YKT.
You guys are in sales. How can you help us overcome this bias, at least for some of us who might have it, that sales is not a good job?
I really enjoy this because there's no limit to the extent at which I can span my skills. I can just take them as far as I want to earn. So for me, I really enjoy this, and I think it's the best place to work in any organization for me. Yeah.
Apart from entrepreneurship, the only other way you can make money working is sales. That's my opinion.
I'm Ebango Umana. I'm the CEO of Brave, which is a workforce planning and recruitment company in Nairobi. The question I really liked wasn't actually asked to me. It was asked to one of the other panelists. It was about, are salespeople required to be extroverts, or can you be different types of personalities?
Yeah.
And what the data shows is that there's no relationship between personality and sales.
Yeah.
Every role in the company is trying to create value for the customer.
Yeah.
So figure out how you do it, and then you're doing sales.
Exactly.
Sales is very serious business. Once you identify the people you want to sell to, you need to build networks below them and have the courage, because these people you're selling to are just normal human beings like you. So don't be afraid to go to a company trying to get someone who's on a lower level and ask them, is this a problem you're facing, and what do you think the budget to solve this problem will be?
The reason why you're feeling upset or fear or problem, because you're relating to the past. So because you had an experience in the past, you're assuming that would happen in the future. And then what happens is that you're going to get lost in the middle, which is right now.
So being in an entrepreneurial space, I usually just focus on being better than yesterday. So if I've reached a certain cap and I don't achieve it on a certain month, it really takes a toll on my emotions. You know, I feel like this is what I decided to do. And if I have a routine of always being better, why didn't I achieve it? For you to be in sales, you need to be emotionally stable. Because if you're passionate about it, it's going to affect you. You want to be better all the time, be consistent with your results. So the fact that sometimes you're not going to meet them, it's okay, but always aspire to be better and to do better than yesterday.
So again, it's about relationships, how you can partner with agencies here and there. Like, so we give like partnership solutions in terms of training, sometimes discounts based on spend levels.
My name is Marcy Wanza. I'm an advocate of the High Court of Kenya. And I also have a startup called Wakili Mkononi with two other partners, so we are three, where you get to get your Wakili on hand. For me, for example, it's business to business, which is B2B, but I've also realized that when you're dealing with humans, you understand that they have a logical part and an emotional part. So there's different ways to it. And I think also understanding that there's a human aspect, there's an emotional aspect, there's a logical aspect, so you engage all of them at the same time and be able to close a successful sales deal. Yeah.
I really liked what you said before about repositioning yourself, not as the advocate for the product, but as a consultant to the person. And then if you do your job right, when you consult them on the spending and how some of that spending should be routed towards you, it's because you're on their side.
Main takeaways, well, there were so many takeaways because we faced this, like a range of topics that was like huge. We went from the compensation to the challenges to the tricks and tips.
My name's Hodan. I work with Oracle, IBM, Click, name it. I managed 40 countries across the world. I took a lot of products from country to country, helping the companies to actually grow and expand themselves into different markets across the globe. And then also I do a particular sales training for actual entrepreneurs for their organization or for themselves individually. So using a coaching model. You can find me on Facebook with Dodi Lion. That's a DODI LION success. You find that in everywhere. Instagram, Facebook, even YouTube.
Nice.
So my website is www.dodilion.com.
Nice.
Or you can always send an email on info@dodilion.com.
I once hired some sales guys, but now I realized 10 months down the line,
It's really nothing. So that begs the question, what strategies can you use to make these people not be comfortable with this retainer?
The length of the contract. So if you can shorten the contract, maybe have 3-month contract for the beginning.
So I think it's not just enough to hire people to do sales for you, but also do the sales. As it doesn't matter your level, because at the end of the day, it's your company actually. And if you can't sell your company better, even those employees cannot sell it better. You understand?
Do you need to be on with him to help him to close the deal, where you can actually support him? If he's lacking the skills, if he's, you know, the sales cycle is, you know, longer than it's what you have experienced, and which stage he is in the sales cycle, and also, which is really important for an CEO, entrepreneur, founder, is that you can have the ability to forecast. So the salespeople must able to forecast when do they expect to close the deal.
There are some people in the company when you're selling who are like champions. They love your product and they can really coach you on how to go about relating to other people that you want to talk, other people that you want to talk to, and it's because you have worked with them, they have been in the company long. And if you have such a person, it's good that you follow the advice and run anything you want to do with them, because you could easily lose a deal by overstepping the wrong people, especially in our market, in this region.
Knowledge is very important. When you're knowledgeable, you're able to communicate it. And also when you're knowledgeable, it gives you confidence.